وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول
الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد. In this episode, inshallah ta'ala, I'm going to speak about Ramadan wal-amalu bil-ilm. The month of Ramadan is a month where we implement the knowledge that we have. What we've understood from the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala becomes actions that are manifesting on our limbs. ولذلك الله سبحانه وتعالى he said in the Qur'an وَنُودُوا أَن تِلْكُمُ الْجَنَّةِ أُورِثْتُمُوهَا بِمَا كُنْتُمْ تَعْمَلُونَ Jannah is inherited by people who act upon the knowledge that they have. In another ayah Allah says فَلَا تَعْلَمُ نَفْسٌ مَا أُخْفِيَ لَهُمْ مِنْ قُرَّةِ عَيُونٍ جَزَاءً بِمَا كَانُوا يَعْمَلُونَ That they do not know, no one knows that which has been prepared for them in Jannah because of the actions and the hard work that they exerted. The work they put in, the effort that they put in, that is why they're inheriting Jannah. That is why they are getting a great place in paradise. So actions of the knowledge that you have gained is a means to enter Jannah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in another ayah, فَكُبْكِبُوا فِيهَا هُمْ وَالْغَاوُونَ It was narrated that Abi Ja'far Muhammad ibn Ali, he commented on this verse, فَكُبْكِبُوا فِيهَا هُمْ وَالْغَاوُونَ Surah Al-Shu'ara, ayah 94. He commented on this verse, and he said that this verse is referring to قَوْمٌ وَصَفُوا الْحَقَّ وَالْعَدْلَ A people who've prescribed, and they described, and they've explained the truth and justice to the people. بِأَلْسِنَتِهِمْ But only on their tongues. وَخَالَفُوهُ إِلَىٰ غَيْرِهِ But they opposed it in their actions. And they did other than that which they were prescribing for the people. And that's what the ayah is referring to by, according to his great imam. Also the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, he said, عِلْمٌ لَا يَنْفَعُ كَكَنْزٍ لَا يُنْفَقُ مِنْهُ Knowledge that doesn't benefit, يعني the knowledge that doesn't become an action implemented, is like a treasure that's not paid anything from it. Knowledge leads to actions. And that is the two things we were created to achieve. The two things that we were created to achieve is knowledge and also actions. Messengers and prophets were sent for that reason. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, هُوَ الَّذِي أَرْسَلَ رَسُولَهُ بِالْهُدَى وَدِينِ الْحَقِّ لِيُظْهِرَهُ عَلَى الدِّينِ كُلِّهِ هو الذي Allah is the one أرسل رسوله he sent him as his messenger بالهدى with guidance ودين الحق and the true religion هدى means العلم النافع ودين الحق means العمل الصالح The Prophet was sent to bring beneficial knowledge and righteous action That is the goal and objective of why Prophets were sent and also the purpose in which we were created And Allah brought us into this world is that we come with beneficial knowledge and righteous action. The evidence for beneficial knowledge is قوله تعالى الله الذي خلق سبع سماوات ومن الأرض مثلهن يتنزل الأمر بينهن لتعلموا أن الله على كل شيء قدير وأن الله قد أحاط بكل شيء علمه Allah tells us that He created the seven heavens, the seven earths, and that which is between it. لتعلموا So you know, so the seven heavens, seven earths, and the creation in between that, all of that, Allah created it. And the reason why He created them all is what? لِتَعْلَمُوا So we can have knowledge. Of what? لِتَعْلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ قَدِيرٍ That Allah has ability over everything. وَأَنَّ اللَّهَ قَدْ أَحَاطَ بِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ عِلْمًا And that Allah تبارك وتعالى has infinite knowledge over everything. So, the first reason is knowledge. The second reason why we were created is actions. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, وَمَا خَلَقَتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ. I did not create the jinn or the ins except to worship me. And in another ayah, Allah says, فَمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُو لِقَاءَ رَبِّهِ فَلْيَعْمَلْ عَمَلًا صَالِحًا وَلَا يُشْرِكْ بِعِبَادَةِ رَبِّهِ أَحَدًا. And the action that we do has to be based on sincerity and also in accordance to the sunnah of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. Then it's called a righteous action. And beneficial knowledge is the knowledge that leads you to beneficial actions, righteous actions. Abu Darda radiallahu ta'ala anhu, a great companion, he said, إِنَّمَا أَخْشَى مِنْ رَبِّي يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. I fear my Lord Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that at the day of judgment, and يَدْعُونِي, that he calls me عَلَى رُؤُوسِ الْخَلَائِقِ, that Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he calls me in front of everyone. فَيَقُولُ لِهِ, he says to me, يَا عُوَيْمِرُ, فَأَقُولُ لَبَّيْكَ رَبِّي, فَيَقُولُ لِي, مَا عَمِلْتَ فِي مَا عَلِمْتَ. That Allah tabarak wa ta'ala calls me, and he says to me, يَا عُوَيْمِرُ, عُوَيْمِرُ, فَأَقُولُ, I say, لَبَّيْكَ, here I am your Lord, in obedience to you. And then it said to me, what did you implement from what you knew? The knowledge that you had, the understanding that was given to you, what did you implement from it? You were given knowledge, but what from that knowledge did you implement? It was also narrated from Hassan al-Basri, rahimahullah. He said, إِذَا ظَهَرَ النَّاسُ الْعِلْمَ, if the people show knowledge, وَضَيَّعُ الْعَمَلَ, and they forsake knowledge, sorry, they forsake righteous action. Hassan al-Basri, rahimahullah, he said, إِذَا ظَهَرَ النَّاسُ الْعِلْمَ, if the people show and they bring out knowledge to the people, وَضَيَّعُ الْعَمَلَ, but they leave off righteous action, وَتَحَابُوا بِالْأَلْسُنِ, and they show love to each other on their tongues, they pretend they love each other, وَتَبَاغَضُوا بِالْقُلُوبِ, but in the hearts they hate each other, وَتَقَاطَعُوا بِالْأَرْحَامِ, and they boycott their family and their relatives, and they cut the ties of kinship, لَعَنَهُمُ اللَّهُ, Allah distances them from His mercy, فَأَصَمَّهُمْ وَأَعْمَى أَبَصَارَهُمْ, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He deafens them and blinds them from seeing. So it's a people who show knowledge, لَكِينَ, they forsake action. They don't do the knowledge and the understanding of what they know. Ali ibn al-Husayn rahimahullah, he said, كَانَ نَقْشُ خَاتَمِي Husayn ibn Ali. Ali ibn al-Husayn is talking about his father, Husayn ibn Ali ibn Abi Talib. So he's the grandson of Ali ibn Abi Talib, Ali ibn al-Husayn. He's talking about his father, Husayn. Hassan and Husayn are the two children of Ali ibn Abi Talib. Husayn ibn Ali, كان نقش خاتمي Husayn ibn Ali, علمت فعمل. On his ring that he wore, it said on it, علمت, you have the knowledge now, implement it. That was written on his ring. It was a reminder for him. Whenever he would look at it, it will remind him that you now have the knowledge, implement the knowledge that you have. Implement the knowledge that you have. Don't just make it information that you gathered and the action and the implementation, you are far from it. Ibn Samak, rahimahullah, he said, كَتَبَ رَجُلٌ إِلَىٰ أَخٍ لَهُ. A brother wrote a letter to another brother of his. And he was saying to him, يَا أَخِي إِنَّكَ قَدْ أُوتِيتَ عِلْمًا. My brother, you have been given knowledge. إِنَّكَ قَدْ أُوتِيتَ عِلْمًا. You were given knowledge. فَلَا تُطْفِئَنَّ نُورَ عِلْمِكَ بِظُلْمَةِ الذُّنُوبِ. Do not extinguish the light of that knowledge that you were given with the darkness of sins. فَتَبْقَى فِي الظُّلْمَةِ. And then you remain in darkness. يَوْمَ يَسْعَى أَهْلُ الْعِلْمِ بِنُورِ عِلْمِهِمْ. The day when the people of knowledge are going to be moving and walking in the light of their knowledge. So this is the advice he gave him. He said to him, my beloved brother, knowledge has been given to you. You have understanding of the religion. Don't extinguish that light Allah gave you, that knowledge Allah gave you. Do not extinguish it with the darkness of sins. And what will happen? You will then be in darkness. And the people of knowledge, the real people of knowledge, who've lived by their knowledge, they are going to be in the lights of their knowledge because they implemented what they knew. They implemented what they knew. Ibn al-Qayyim rahimahullah, he said, Al-ilmu imamul amali wa qa'idun lah wal-amalu tabi'un lahu wa mu'tammun bih. Ibn al-Qayyim said that knowledge is the leader of action. It is leader. Yani the leader is knowledge and action follows. So when you have knowledge, your actions follow. وَالْعَمَلُ تَابِعُ لَهُ And the actions are the one that follows and it's entrusted with it. Yani a leader, a commander, a general has to have soldiers. Or else, what fight or what battle is he going to participate in? The same way, a person who has knowledge has to have actions that follow up that knowledge. Or else, what is the benefit of that knowledge? Look how deep he looked at it. Al-Allama ibn al-Qayyim. So the month of Ramadan, my beloved brothers and sisters, is a month of implementing your knowledge. Learning jurisprudent rulings regarding Ramadan, the do's and the don'ts. Spiritually uplifting yourself, nurturing yourself upon Islamic ethics and living by that. Changing your life for the better. A lot of people, what they do is they look at every new year and they set themselves goals. And they say, this year I'm going to achieve this, this year I'm going to do this, and this year I'm going to do that. Well, guess what? Ramadan is in. You are now fasting the month of Ramadan. Have you set yourself goals, things that you're going to do in Ramadan and things that you will inshallah ta'ala do after Ramadan is gone? Set yourself that goal inshallah ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive me for anything I might have said that was wrong or incorrect. And Allah and His Messenger are free from those mistakes and errors. Subhanakallahumma bihamdik ashhadu an la ilaha illallah astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.
Assalamu alaikum. If you're enjoying these videos and you'd like to keep up to date with all of the courses we're going to be running, make sure you head over to amauathome.com.